Hello friends, welcome to this next video on integral equation. In the last video, what we have done, we have seen a method to solve an integral equation when we have it as the Fredholm type integral equation of second kind with degenerate kernel, right? In this video, I will give an example that the theory which we have developed in the last video, we'll try to implement that theory here. So the question given to you is solve the integral equation of second kind. This is the integral equation which is given to you, and you can see that here you have a function fs here, and your this function is 1, therefore it is of second kind, and then you have 0 to 1, so limits are fixed. That is why it is Fredholm type equation, right? And one more thing which you have to notice is look at this kernel. Here you have kernel, a function of s and then a function of t, plus a function of s and a function of t. So this is a degenerate kernel, and we have in the last video studied the theory when we have a degenerate kernel. So the theory which we have learnt in the last video is applicable here for sure, right? So there are two ways to proceed. One is you start from the scratch, right? We have done in the last video, or you can just remember that you have to break your integral equation into a system like this, c is equal to f. In that case, you should know what are your c and f. I will recommend the second approach because every time it is not very convenient to start from scratch. So you should know that your system is going to be transferred into a system like this, 1 minus lambda a 1 1, then you have 1 2 and so on, is equal to f1 f2 fn. Here you have your c. So you should know what are ai's and what are these fi's, right? So we had first of all, what you have to do, you have to look at your degenerate kernel. You have to find out what is a1s. a1s is the function which is in the first term and a function of s. So you look at this term st square, so you have a1s is equal to s, and you look at this term again, look for the function of t, that is t square, so your b1t is t square. Now go to the second term, look at the function of s, that is s square, so your a2s is s square, and then go to the second term again, you look for the function of t, it is t, right? Here we had only two terms in our degenerate kernel, so that is why we are stopping at 2. Otherwise, if you have three terms, then you will have a3 and b3 also, right, and so on. Okay, now having found out your a1, a2, b1 and b2, we will find out a11, a12, a21, a22, and we will find out f1 and f2. So whatever are the number of terms is the number of terms in the degenerate kernel, and the same order of the system we will get in the end, right? So here we have two terms in our degenerate kernel, that is why the system is going to be of 2 cross 2, right? Okay, now what was the formula for a11? a11 was b1t a1t dt, a12 was b2t a1t. So generally you have to find remember that aij is, first you have to take bj, and then you have to take ai, and you have to integrate it. That is how you will get your aij, right? Okay, so let us look at what is a11, a12, a21 and a22. Okay, so a11 is going to be integral of b1 and a1. So b1 and a1 are here, but you have to put them as a function of t both, so it is going to be t. B1 is t square, so b1 is t square, and a1s is s, so a1t is going to be t, so you have t cube dt, so this is equal to 1 by 4 because you are integrating from 0 to 1. Similarly, a12 is going to be b2t a1t, and your b2t is t, and a1t is again t, so you have t square dt, so you will get 1 by 3. And similarly, you can move further, your a21 is going to be 1 by 5 and a22 is going to be 1 by 4. Now let us look at f1 and f2. The definition for fi is you have to integrate ft with respect to bit dt, right? For I is equal to 1 to n. Here you have 2, n is equal to 2, so your f1 is going to 0 to 1 ft b1t. Ft is this function, right? So that is why here fs is s, so ft is going to be t. And what is your b1t? Here it is, right? So you have t square dt, so you have t cube integral 0 to 1, so that is going to be equal to 1 by 4. And similarly, you can compute your f2, that is going to be 1 by 3. Now you have everything with you, just write down the system. You should remember how to write down the system. It was like 1 minus a11 lambda minus lambda a12 minus lambda a21, 1 minus lambda a22, right? So I have written it here. You can just put the values of a11 is 1 by 4, a12 is 1 by 3, and so on. And on the right hand side, here is your left hand side, you have the unknown vector, and the right hand side you have to put the values of f1 and f2 that we have computed as 1 by 4 and 1 by 3, right? So this is the final system which you are going to get. Now you have to find a solution of the system. For that, basically you have to invert this matrix, this particular matrix you want to invert, right? And for that you have to look at its determinant. Here I have just found out the determinant. I think all of you know how to find out the determinant of the matrix. So this is the term which I have obtained. This is the determinant, and then I have found out the inverse. Inverse is equal to 1 upon determinant. So this is the term 1 upon determinant, and you have to write the adjoint. But in case of a 2 cross 2 matrix, I think it is simple to write the adjoint. So how can you do that? You just transpose these two numbers, switch their position, but because here they are same, so we don't get anything, and put a negative sign here. So that is how you find out the adjoint. But you can go by traditional method also, traditional way of finding the adjoint. Okay, so this is the inverse which we have obtained, which is not always easy when you have bigger matrices. Here we had a 2 cross 2 matrix, so we have easily found out the inverse. But when you have a 5 cross 5 matrix, you may have problems. You then have to go for computers. So that is why, again, you have found out your A inverse. So C1, C2 is going to be A inverse into F1, F2. So A inverse, you have just found out this, into F1, F2, right? So final solution is going to be this. So you have obtained your C1 is equal to this quantity and C2 equal to this quantity. And also you should remember that final answer is going to be this. Final answer is F1, Fs, which we already know, given in the equation, plus lambda times C1 into A1s plus C2 into A2s. So the solution was like this. G of s is equal to F of s plus summation I from 1 to n, lambda was here, and then you had Ci Ais. This is how your solution was. You can see that your A1s is s and A2s is s squared. Go back to the initial page. So you have A1s is equal to s and A2s is equal to s squared. So right, finally you have to write down the solution. So we get the solution as just switch, insert the values. F of s is s, lambda is as such, s is as such, c1 value we have just computed, so just put it here, plus lambda your s square, that is the value of a2, and then this is value of c2. The final answer is here. Of course you should note that it should not be zero. When this is equal to zero, then we are in the further videos we will see that what happens when for some value of lambda this determinant is zero. Here we are talking when determinant is non-zero, right? That we assume that this is not equal to zero. In the further videos we will see what happens when this determinant is zero. Thank you.